So this is my project for Cal 2 fall 2021. My project was to push a car 10 feet and then figure out how much force it would take to do that. So in the next part, you'll see me measure the distance, and then right after that, you'll see me push a car. And then the last step, of course, is the math. And then we'll go from there. Now in this part, we're gonna measure out 10 feet because that's the distance I want to push my car. And then from there, we'll get the measurements.
I don't know where to...
Yeah. Oh. Now this part, I'm going to demonstrate me pushing my car back 10 feet. And then from there, we will get the measurements and all that and calculate it later from here. Now I'm going to be pushing my car. Alright, so now that we push my car, we can figure out the math behind trying to get the force of the equation. So to start out, my weight is 3,449 pounds. So first, we have to get that into mass, which equals kilograms. So to get it there, weight equals mass times gravity, gravity being 9.8 meters a second. So 3,449 equals m times 9.8 divided 9.8. My m equals 351.94. All right, so now that we got our mass, we have the equation F equals MA. So we have one, now we just have to get the second. Our acceleration can be determined by time and distance. So the distance that I pushed the car was 10 feet. My time to push it was 10 seconds. So now that we have distance and time, we can find our velocity, which is equal to 1 foot per second. So now we have to get 1 foot into meters per second, which V equals, to do the conversion, all you have to do is determine how many feet or how many meters are in the feet, which is 0.3048 in a foot. So if we're going 1 foot a second, that would be 0.308 meters a second. All right, so now we have our mass and acceleration. So our mass was 351.94. Now all we have to do is multiply that by 0.3048. To get our force, and our force will be 107.3 newtons. And that is how you find the force.